Contestant number seven, Muhammad Hafiz Ismail. His speech, One More Day. One More Day, Muhammad Hafiz Ismail.
Good afternoon, everyone, fellow Toastmasters and guests. Now, I might be appearing to you guys as being very, very vibrant. I don't know why. It's either this suit or maybe the stage itself, because it's really my first time being on such a fabulous stage in front of a fantastic audience. And I'm feeling really fantastic today. Although, let's stop talking about myself for a moment, because I want to focus on the people who are being sad right now. Not because they don't get a chance to eat pizzas or to eat McDonald's, or maybe those who are going to be sad because they lost for the election tomorrow, or those who will be sad for losing a public speaking competition for today, something like that. But those who have lost someone that is very dear to them, someone that they hold so dear to themselves. And those being, when I say this to myself, those loved ones are my own parents. They are very, very close to me. Losing someone that you love, it's not easy. It's really, really difficult. It's not an easy thing to go through. Trust me, because I have a friend who recently, his father passed away. So it's the thing is about losing someone that is very close to you, you will never get a warning. Nobody's going to text you saying, hey, your dad's gonna die in 20 seconds. No. No one knows when their time will come. And seeing my friend, a phone call is all that it was needed to turn his smile upside down. One moment he was fine, he was smiling, he was grinning from ear to ear. And then a phone call changed everything. He rushed to his home, and then all he saw was his father laying there, not breathing. And it's such a sad thing to me, because he didn't get to hear his father's voice for the last time. This is when it occurred to him that he wished that there was just one more day that he could have with his parents. Just one more day. Is it so much to ask for? If it's not one more day, why not just a few minutes, just to say that I love you, Dad, or maybe for the father to tell his son, I love you too. Now, I know that the majority of you here are already happily married, but they say that marriage is when two single persons die, but I don't know about that. But when Joshua said that smoking is the same as marriage, it's like a cigarette, it drains the life out of you until you die, well, I'm having second thoughts about marriage right now. Because most of the previous speakers talked so badly about marriage, now I'm getting second thoughts about it. But here, what I'm actually trying to lead to is that those of you who are already married and have children, after this competition, after this speech, it would be good if you just do me one small favor. Just go, or better yet, if you bring your child right now, just go sit next to them and tell them that you love them. Because you will never know the last time that you will have that you can say those three words. Those three words mean so much. It's just three words, but yet it can change everything, such as turning your life from a normal life into a living hell by marriage, something like that. But what I'm trying to say is that after this, just tell them that you love them. It's so simple. And yes, you'll never know how long that you're gonna live. You'll never know when your time will come. So it's better yet if you were to prepare it right now. After this, go back to your home give your child a hug, give your wife a hug, and tell them that you love them, or for those women, hug your husbands or something like that. And tell them that you love them, even though you've been at each other, scolding each other for a lifetime or so, but deep down, if both of you are not perfect, but you guys are perfect for each other. That I found that quote something on the internet. But since I'm still a child, I don't know anything about love yet, so I'll just stick to the original plan to get married later on, when I'm more mature. But yeah, what I'm trying to say is, just just go back home and tell them that you love them. Before going to vote for tomorrow, just tell, well, okay, just tell to your daughter, tell to your son, I'm going on a very dangerous mission. Pray hard for me, but know that I will always love you. Something like that. It sounds more dramatic that way. I love to make it sound more dramatic. But I think I read on something about public speakers having a longer lifespan when engaging in public speaking activities. So maybe most of us don't have to worry about dying yet. So I think that's all for me. Thank you.